we are going to see how you can create a CSV file and how you can extract the CSV file and make a data frame. Okay, so what do you mean by a CSV file? So CSV file means a comma separated range. So here, as you can see, suppose these are the roll numbers, these are the marks. Okay, so here I have, suppose this one is a one column, this one is one column, this one is one column, because in data frame there are different columns. So therefore these three are taken as a column. So you have to split the values using comma. Means this one is the first row with comma separated values, okay? Then second row with comma separated values and third row with comma separated values. Now this, to make it a CSV file, by default in Notepad, when you are saving a file, it will be t.txt. But for CSV, you have to give a name and you have to write the extension dot. Here, after the file name, you have to put dot. Then after that, you have to write CSV. So it will be saved as a CSV file, means comma separated values. Now, to extract this file from the, when you save it, so it will be in your PC. Then if you want to extract this file in the data frame, then how you can do it? So you have to use this code. Okay, so import pandas, first you have to import pandas, then write df data frame is equal to pandas.read CSV. So this is the function to read the CSV file. Then next is f colon, then python, then here text for df. So text for df is the file name which I have used here. This is text for df. So file, this is text for df.csv is the file name and the other extension is there. So in the extension part, you have to remember that in all the extensions that is used, they mainly use a single slash. But here, everywhere you have to use the double slash. Means here double slash, this is the drive name, then this is the folder name, then this is the again the double slash, then this is the file name. So, okay, this is the drive name, this is the folder name, and this is the file name. And after that, since I have taken these values which don't have any column name, okay, so since these don't have any column name, so you have to mention a column name yourself. So here I have used backslash, so to make it to come to the new line, then write names. So names means the name of the column. So here I have written what? A, B and C, these are the columns name within box bracket. So when I print the data frame, then you will get what in the output? A, B, C. So here A, B and C, and after that, since the these indexes are not mentioned, so therefore 0, 1 and 2 means the index value is there. So in this way, you can create a data frame from a CSV file using the read CSV. Okay, so that's all for this tutorial. In the next tutorial, we will learn some more things about this, okay, and this I will give it as a project for the second S3 to extract the CSV file and to make plots using this data frame. Okay, thank you.